The Discover Card Countdown to Green continues live from Chicagoland here on NBC. Every driver in the top five in the championship standings has multiple wins this season. Every driver in the top five in the standings except Tony Stewart. Stewart, fourth in the standings, is the only guy in the top five to finish every race. He just hasn't finished any of them in victory lane. For the talented but temperamental Stewart, this has been a season of heat and defeat.
The competitive fire in me says, yeah, I mean, anything but a win doesn't count. With the season that I'm having this year, with the fact that I haven't been in victory lane yet, it is something that eats at you.
Vindicated, I am selfish, I am wrong, I am right, I swear I'm right, swear I knew it all along, and I am flawed, but I am cleaning up so well, I am seeing in me now the things you saw, you saw yourself. My hope dangles on a string, like slow spinning redemption.
Standing by with Tony Stewart now, and Smoke, fourth in the championship chase. You haven't won a race yet this year, but are you satisfied with the consistency of your group this year?
Well, I mean, we always are looking to be better than what we are, so you're never satisfied unless you're winning every race you run. But, you know, we had a good weekend last weekend at Daytona, you know, a good week before, so I feel like that, you know, this team's starting to build the momentum. It's a little late for our time frame as far as when we normally get going really well, but seems like we're getting back on track finally.
And this is first time in forever that you have had a start in a backup car that wrecked in practice, right? How good is it?
It's pretty good. I mean, Zippy and I sat down yesterday and a couple of the engineers in the trailer and just talked about things that we thought were we could do to make it a little faster and, you know, really get into detail what I was feeling in the car. So, you know, Zippy's really good at making things happen overnight on Saturday night. So I'm pretty sure this Home Depot Monte Carlo is going to be pretty good today.
All right, Smoke's got a lot of people cheering for him, including a couple of Olympians as well here this weekend. So got a lot of support behind him, Matt.
Dave, one of the biggest topics of conversation in the garage area this morning was today's heat. And Kurt Busch, how will that not only affect the race car on the track, but also the drivers?
Yeah, we do the best we can to prepare for heat at Sharpie by running a black car.
And a black uniform.
Black three-layer Alpine Star suit. I don't know what we've got going on with the heat, but I think the way that you can adjust to it is to have a setup that is adjustable. We've been playing around with 80-degree temperatures all week, and it's been cooler out. Today, just the heat index has risen, and therefore it's going to abuse these tires more quickly, and we just have to make sure we don't burn the right front off the car like we saw yesterday.
You're seventh in points. How do you approach the final nine leading into the final 10?
We can't wait to get to the final 10. We've got tests set aside. We've already prepared for Loudon. We've got all those races that'll be in the final 10 that we've prepared for. So these few that we've got coming up, we got to make sure that we just do the best job that we can, make the right calls on pit road, and whether it's the lead draft, stick with them like at Daytona, or whether it's a short track, and we've got to stay up front and have solid pit stops. It's just a team effort, and I think that we can do that and put together some solid finishes that'll lock us in that top 10, I hope.
Kurt Busch, last one back in the spring at Bristol, chasing his season second win. He rolls off 21st. Marty?
Matt, this is what's great about the chase for the championship. A guy like Rusty Wallace, who is 17th, still has a shot to win the championship. How realistic do you feel in nine races, with nine races to go before the cutoff, that you can get into this chase?
Well, I got to get into it. I mean, I want to get into it real, real bad, so I can't predict anything except say I'm going to give it my all. And we've had really fast cars all year long. And tell you the truth, the last five or six runs have been all top five runs, only to be spoiled by crazy things. You know, run out of gas with one lap to go, running fourth in California, blow an engine running fourth in Michigan, stuff like that, you know. So we just got to finish these races, and the performance has been doing all right.
And you've had this date circled on your calendar since last year. Running second, broke a transmission coming to pit road.
Yeah, great car last year, and I got a great car this time, too.
And he was sixth fastest in yesterday's final practice. Bill?
Thanks, Marty. Jeff Burton has 17 career victories. The most recent one came at Phoenix in October of 2001. That was 93 races ago. Today, Jeff Burton starts sixth. That's the exact same starting position he had in his very first Nextel Cup Series race, exactly 11 years ago today, July 11th, 1993 at Loudon, New Hampshire. The last time the series raced on this date was 5 years ago in New Hampshire. That was on July 11th, 1999. The winner that day in car 99 was Jeff Burton. Now, you don't have to look it up because we already did. The countdown is at zero, and the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series returns to NBC next.
This has been the Discover Card Countdown to Green. Let's go racing.
And NBC Sports presents the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series, live from the Chicagoland Speedway in Joliet, Illinois. The stars of the Nextel Cup Series are on pit road, poised for the 18th race of the season. 16 drivers broke the track record in qualifying, led by 32-year-old Jeff Gordon. On the pole for the fourth straight race, chasing his third straight win, and hoping for another big day in a career full of accomplishments.
If I traded it all, if I gave it all away for one thing, just for one thing, if I sold it all, if I knew all of this one thing, wouldn't that be so?
Jeff Gordon, Jeff Gordon wins.
Welcome to the Chicagoland Speedway in Joliet, Illinois, everybody. I'm Bill Weber. The NASCAR Nextel Cup Series hits the halfway mark this afternoon, and it's time to determine who will be in that 10-race shootout that will determine the 2004 Series Championship. 9 races remain on the road to Richmond. That's when the field will be chopped, and 10 men and everyone within 400 points of the championship leader will be eligible to capture the cup. Young talent has been exceptionally strong and exciting this season. 4 of the top 6 positions in the championship standings are held by former champions. And some of the most popular veterans in this sport, some that have been to victory lane and some that have not, must start to make their move today or they will be locked out of the championship chase. We're heading to a 3:33 Eastern time green flag this afternoon here at Chicagoland. Jimmy Johnson leads the points, chased by Dale Earnhardt. Everyone else trying to catch up. Jeff Gordon has 4 straight poles. Today he goes for his 3rd straight win. Casey Kane looking for his first win of the season. He has 4 second place finishes. Kevin Harvick won here the first 2 times the Nextel Cup Series came to Chicagoland, but was disappointed 1 year ago. He's the defending champion at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway. Brian Vickers, a talented rookie, running under the Hendrick Motorsports banner along with Jimmy Johnson, hoping to go to victory lane and follow in the footsteps of Jeff Gordon. Trackside for the pre-race ceremonies.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you please rise and remove your hats as the United States Marine Corps presents our national colors. Please welcome Kenny Crosthwaite, chaplain for Motor Racing Outreach Ministries, as he delivers today's invocation.
Father, we pause now to acknowledge your presence. We thank you for the provision for all of our needs, both spiritually and physically. Father, we ask for your protection here today in Chicago for those outside the track, inside and on the track. And we ask that you would help us be appreciative at the end of this day for the life that you give us. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing as country music sensation and multi-platinum RCA recording artist Sarah Evans performs our national anthem.
Streaming, and the rockets' red glare.
13 races down, 19 to go. Every driver and every crew member knows the championship is awarded on a cold December night, but you earn it in the heat of a season of summer Sundays. Get ready to turn up the heat. NASCAR Nextel Cup Racing from Chicagoland Speedway is brought to you by Nextel Coast to Coast Walkie Talkie. Nextel, done. By Stacker 2 of Federa Free. Real people, real stories, real results. By the new M3 Power from Gillette. Feel the power of the world's best shave. And by Levitra. Ask your doctor about it today. Levitra, when it counts. For the last 16 races, this is the moment when I would sit up and say, damn, I wish I was there. Well, my wish came true. And for the next 19 races, we will take you to the green flag, through the field, inside the field, back to the garage to talk to the guys that didn't win, and into victory lane to celebrate with the guys who did. In the driver's seat for the chase for the Nextel Cup, our boys in the booth, their dream came true too. Alan Bestwick, Wally Dallenbach, and Benny Parsons.
Bill, thanks. Really glad to be here and ready to get this race to the chase underway. Today's event's going to kind of be like a chess game, except instead of capturing the king, you're going to have to use your strategy to capture that number one spot. Some people are going to have to play some moves to make this happen.
That's a phrase we're going to hear all day today. Track position. Jeff Gordon, as he goes for three in a row, he's perfect in the pole position. Elliott Sadler in a pre-race show talked about four tires and fuel. We'll see just fuel today. We'll see two tires all trying to get that wonderful track position in front, because it's so important to get there, to get all that air over your car, to get that downforce you need to go to victory circle.
Guy out front's got the advantage. Everybody else still has to pass him. Wally, in yesterday's NASCAR Busch Series race, we saw a couple guys leading have troubles with right front tires. What did you hear about that this morning in the garage area?
Yeah, there were some tire issues yesterday in the race, and I talked to a couple of crew chiefs, one being Jimmy Johnson's crew chief, Chad Knauss, and he really wasn't concerned with the problem like Matt Kenseth had. Matt Kenseth in the Busch race had a tire split like that, and the reason for that is they're starting them down on too low air pressures. They get too much heat too fast and they split. What he was concerned about was inconsistency in tires. Sometimes they get a set of tires that just isn't like anything else they've had. That's going to kill them in this race. That's really going to put them back if they get one of those sets.
So we might see a little drama here. Guy that has a great car and leads 300 miles suddenly starts going backwards in the final 100.
And we'll know why.
We'll know why. BP, we're ready to go.
I'm ready to go. Let's do it.
All right. The race to the chase. 9 races to go before that cutoff point to see who gets to contend for the championship. It starts here today in Chicagoland. 43 drivers and teams set to go down on pit road. All they're waiting for to get this 400-mile race underway are those four famous words we'll get trackside.
And now, race fans, please welcome back our Grand Marshal, the promotional winner from Meyer Stores, John Samuels, for the most famous words in motorsports.
Gentlemen, start your engines.
Cup and Jeff Gordon trying for 3 straight wins. Unfolds next. You're watching NASCAR on NBC.